Okay. If at any point in this meditation you find yourself drifting off, then be aware that this is where your energy frequency is strong enough to manage. And the more you practice with this, you'll see that you can keep awareness for longer and more. So relax your, give your feet permission to relax. As before, you may find that you're like almost immediately and automatically going back into full alignment as we were before. As you give your feet permission to relax, your root chakra automatically and naturally opens. All that beautiful energy flows through your legs, deep into earth. And as the energy is flowing through you, you'll notice the top of your head automatically, naturally feels light, airy, and tingly as your crown chakra opens up to flow more energy into your body, through the top of your head, down through your body, through your legs, through your feet, deep into earth. Take a moment and play with your root chakra and your crown chakra, expanding either wider or deeper or both with your root chakra, and then giving your crown chakra permission to expand higher or wider, feeling whichever direction is most comfortable. Again, you do not take action, you just give permission and make requests of your feet and root chakra, of the top of your head and crown chakra, and invite them to do the work, feeling how the energy flows through your body, and feeling how every adjustment impacts the energy flow. Give yourself a few minutes to play with this adjustment until you feel completely resonant and flowing straight through. The energy is flowing through your body. Anytime you feel any pressure on your head, invite your crown chakra to adjust. And anytime you feel any constraint, invite your root chakra to adjust. Now with this energy flowing, we are going to invite your inner energy grid to activate. Starting with the bones in your feet, as the energy, the divine energy is flowing through your body, through your conduit, through your flesh, invite the bones of your feet to activate, to light up. The marrow of your bones, the porous structure of your bones is lighting up. You may see it lit up, may even be specific colors. You may just feel it lit up or have an awareness. And invite the light of the inside of your bones to rise up through your legs, your calves, ankles, shins, up to your knee. Invite your kneecaps and the joints within your knees to light up, to energize. You may feel like there's even extra energy in your legs. Like now even the flesh of your shins and calves are becoming too energized, like restless leg syndrome. If so, invite the energy to emanate out around your legs. It does not need to be contained by your skin. And as your kneecaps are lit up, and the joints on either side of the inner knee, all of that lit up bone energy, your core energy, is also focusing in on the insides of your knee joints and the tissues, the soft tissues, the liquids, sending inner health and vitality to the insides of your knee joints. You may even feel like your knee joints are growing a little bit. If there's any areas that need healing, redefining for optimum physical and energetic health, invite that to occur without your taking action, but just giving permission. Any extra energy is invited to emanate in the air around your leg. And then allow the bones running up through your thighs, your upper legs, to your hips to activate and light up. Send their energy outward. Filling the space around you. You may even feel like your behind has become on fire. And up through your tailbone and your hip bones and your joints, we activate. Activate all the bone energy. And you'll notice as you activate your hip bone and your tailbone, your root chakra becomes charged up. Your root chakra, which nestles in the bowl of this area of your hip bones and your tailbones, and all of your bone energy that's rising up to your root chakra creates a ball of light within you. You may feel it even being electric or blossoming. You may feel some of this overt energy then pouring down through the root chakra energy back into earth, back with all of the energy flowing through your hollow bone, creating a little cycle of energy, bone energy emanating outward to connect with chakra energy flowing back downward. Bring your awareness into your root chakra. which may perceive initially as like a ball of red light, but in actuality, it is a network. This chakra, as we call it, is actually a mandala, a grid of many crossings of energy, of physical energy, of nerves and of veins and arteries and organs, and of spiritual energy, your groundedness, your connection to earth, of romantic energy, and of waste energy. Your root chakra encompasses where all of the energy of your body leaves your body. Allow your awareness to go into the network that is your root chakra and explore the many cross lines of energy, the balls of energy, the mechanisms of energy in there, in whatever way they present to you. Are there any areas that feel extra powerful or uncomfortable? Explore them. If there is any discomfort, give it permission to resolve itself or express any messages it wishes to share. Are there any areas that seem, any connections, elements that seem weaker than others that could use a little extra energy directed or diverted to them? Explore the grid, the network of your root chakra. You might explore it as you would a tapestry that may need some repairing, or electrical wiring that you are analyzing to make sure it is completely sound. Or a musical composition, are all the notes in harmonious value? So now invite the root chakra to anchor deep and wide into earth and remain as is, powerful, grounded, activated. And we will bring our attention to the top of our head, to our crown chakra. Give yourself a moment to adjust. If you're feeling any kind of queasiness or vertigo or pressure or pain, request the crown chakra adjust its frequency and direction, height and width, to accommodate the maximum healthiest flow through your being at this time. You'll notice as the crown chakra is bringing energy into your body through the top of your head, your third eye chakra is also very activated, both in your forehead pointing forward and the bottom part of the back of your head, just above the back of your neck, the top of your neck, pointing backwards. Invite your third eye to activate both forward and backward, and to expand as wide as it would like to be. You may even feel like your entire face and the entire back of your head are both activated fully to accommodate this beautiful energetic radiance and to support your expansive crown chakra. As your crown chakra is comfortably adjusting to the activated third eye, you may even feel like the crown chakra is nestled into the third eye. The third eye and crown chakra may even feel increasingly like one thing, or two things beautifully blended, wherever is your comfort. In the core of all of this, of course, where third eye meets crown, is your pineal gland. Beautiful gland that, like the heart, is both physical and spiritually energetic. You do not need to take any action. The merging of your third eye and your crown automatically light up your pineal gland. Activate. And you could feel from your pineal gland near the center of your brain all of the neurons and synapses in your brain immediately become alive and activate. Explore with your awareness the lighting up of your brain function, your pathways in your mind. Feel how your awareness of your third eye and crown and the energy that they flow with and create impact all of this extraordinary activity in your brain and your active pineal gland. All of this energy in your mind and around your head naturally, instinctively activates the bone energy of your skull and your jaw, your nose and ears, allowing your bone energy to activate and light up. which even further empowers your crown chakra, your third eye, your inner brain activity to become a higher frequency. A frequency of awareness. Resonate with all of this active light in and around, flowing into and emanating from your head, your brain, your chakras. Allow your awareness to flow through the lobes of your brain, the neurons, the veins, the energetic ways, pathways. As with your root chakra, invite your crown and third eye, your head chakra, to remain as powerful as it is. Bring all this energy into your heart space, up from the root, down from the head. Fill your heart. And in the process, fill your entire being with this energy. You may include and incorporate any of the other chakras as you wish. Take a moment to secure your root chakra, so strong, powerful, and your crown chakra, ever reaching and brilliantly enlightened. And all of this energy flowing in to your heart chakra. And from your heart chakra, allow it to just emanate outward. Take a moment to explore the inner workings of your body as they all lead from divine and sacred to heart. Allow your heart to just emanate, flow, ooze, gush all of this beautiful energy outward in any direction. All of this love that you are flowing with, allows an environment for your guides, your guardian angel, your soul family, those who love you of the non-physical to come closer. They're already here. They're always here. Invite your awareness to sense at this moment whom you are feeling. It may be one, it may be many. Whom you are feeling? Are you feeling them within you, wrapped around you, whispering in your ear, standing before you, ready to be of service? Where is your guide, and how, where are they connecting with you at this moment? So I promise your guides are here. Allow the one that resonates the closest to you at this moment to resonate bright enough that you can communicate in whatever way works best for you. At this moment, as your heart is flowing with this beautiful love, connect with your guide, your friend, your non-physical darling. Invite this being to absorb into your body and join you in your heart center to increase and amplify the love in you and to whichever part of your being you wish to invite them to. Absorb your non-physical guide into yourself and allow your frequencies to harmonize within your body. Invite your root chakra and your crown chakra and your heart space to adjust and adapt. And allow this new frequency to resonate with you. Invite your root chakra and crown to re-adapt again, to become more energy, more love, more flow, more emanation. Ask your friend to do the same, to expand their energy flow, their chakras, wherever they are coming from their guides and guardians, to fill your being with even more love through their pathways. Your physical body is flowing with the divine love of two beings. Your friend who is one with you is bringing frequencies from where they come from, another dimension, another resonance. Invite this to flow in through you, filling your heart outward, flow down through your root into earth, this harmonious resonance. invite your friend to imprint any part of their resonance that your being craves, to imprint it into you so that you may maintain this energetic state whenever you wish. You may even bring your awareness through your friend up through their crown chakra to their energy source, a portal, a grid, a collective, and allow your crown chakra to also connect there so that you may be flowing a divine conduit of healing love directly from this resource through you to Earth. Take a moment and feel, with your friend's help, the energy going all the way up to their resource, and let that energy flow completely through you, so that you may evermore be a conduit of this harmonious blend of divine love for healing Earth. Let it resonate with you and become very natural. Any area of you that feels tense or achy, or acknowledge it, reassure it. This is a friendly frequency that we welcome for harmonious, full existence love. And then invite the energy to continue flowing. In through you, through your crown, through your hearts, your body, into Earth. Down through your arms, your hands. So all that you touch with your fingers will receive this divine love from your palms, your fingers, even the brush of the back of your hand when passing in the street. This love that's flowing in through you, you may pick any target and direct one revenue of love stream to your target of choice and anchor it. If you'd like, you can even dance and send love flowing everywhere that your body swirls and leaps to. You may sing, and the notes of love fly out, and frequency of love goes through the solid objects even, You can send any lines of love or pellets of love, rainbows of love, wherever you like. Now take a moment to share gratitude with this one who loves you so dearly and connects with you so perfectly that you are able to share space together. And while you allow the separation of selves, the connection is there. And the return of shared space may happen whenever you wish. With just a request. And certainly the rapport is there. The ability to maintain communication, to chat with each other, to heal beside or within each other. Perhaps the next time you will go into your friend's being and feel what it is to love through their way of existing. You might even twine and weave together and then reach out your hands to invite others to join you. For this moment, we invite the joyous love to remain as you and your beloved friend of the non-physical separate back to your two spaces, maintaining your happy connection with absolute gratitude that now that you know each other so well, you are always there for each other. You are invited to maintain your flow of love and energy as we return to this space and this time, and this room. And know whenever you wish to be in this alignment again, all you need to do is invite your feet to relax, set your intention. The rest is inevitable. Lovely.